So that's 160 watts L2 laser by Atezr with the maximum laser module power capability of up to 36 watts. This means that it can cut a wooden piece of up to 30 mm thickness in a single pass. That is literally the most powerful laser I have ever used, and it has a maximum sintering temperature of up to 3000 degrees. Now, the lasers look cool, but they are dangerous, so the company has provided us with several protective features like the child safety lock, the second one is the tilt protection, the third one is the fire sensing, and the fourth one are the limit switches, two for each axis. Now, moving on to the three best features of this laser. The first one that I like the most is the laser autofocus, the Z axis with which you get the best precise output for the work that you are doing. The second one is the automatic resume function with which you can resume your work after there has been a power outage. The third one is the speed. It is 54,000 millimeters per minute. It is so high. Finally, the engraving precision of 0.01 mm and a work area of 410 x 410 mm. Quite generous. M4 screws. So here are some tests that I've done with my new laser. So the first one is the engrave test. I have made this flower. It's quite good. Next, these are some cuts that I've made on a 2mm MDF board at 58% power and 486 speed millimeters per minute. And it turned out pretty good. Same for this one. Now, this piece is a little bigger. See these small rectangles? It is so accurate with the cuts. This is a keyring that I've made for someone. See, the wooden piece is quite thick. It is 5 mm and it turned out pretty good. Next, this wooden piece was lying around, discarded, so I tried testing on it, and here we have another keyring, and this also turned out pretty good. Moving on to this part, I've engraved this pencil, and there was some problem, like while I was trying to cut a piece through the MDF board, the framing was on this side, but it started cutting on this side. Yeah, I don't know why that happened, but I still have to figure that out. Maybe that is the software problem, at least that's what I believe, because this pencil, I tried engraving it after that, but this one was in place, like where I wanted it to be. So maybe there's an issue with the light burn. The cut problem was when I was using light burn, and the pencil was when I was using the laser GRBL. These are the remaining wooden pieces. See, also tried some holes before figuring out the exact power needed for cutting this MDF board. I think it is very useful for getting the precise cut, minimum power consumption, and better finish. So that's all for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you so much for watching. Please hit like and don't forget to share and subscribe.